If Anyone Has an Ear, Let Him Hear by Terry Buckingham, livingwaterpress.com.
The day of the Lord is at hand. You've heard this said for so long that you begin to think it will never come. But it must come, children, and it is come. Now. Children, you know this is true in your spirits. How much more one world of a government will you need to see to register this fact in your conscious minds? Somehow, someone, somewhere has pulled enough strings and twisted enough arms to convince the entire world, from the person hiding in the remotest hostel of the biggest city to the person lying on the most deserted beach in the most deserted island. Everyone, everywhere, is afraid of the same scare, the virus scare. And although every government in every locale is being allowed to respond to it somewhat uniquely, they have all uniformly been forced to respond, all of them. No government has been allowed to completely ignore it. Every city, every business, every mom and pop store on every corner must address the virus scare. This is the end. This is the end. It's the end of time. I've said in my word that I allow the devil 42 months of authority on earth. This 42 months has not begun yet, but it begins very, very soon. And once it does, the whole earth, not just your campus or your church or your nearby vicinity, will be on lockdown. Travel will be greatly hindered. Everything will be much more difficult to come by. Individual commerce, not under the banner of government, will become almost non-existent. And soon the entire world marketplace will be under the control of the beast, the Antichrist. There is so little time. Your best option, your absolute best option, is to serve me, to reject the Antichrist and to lose your life doing it, if that's what comes of it. For if you are willing to lose your life for me now, you will surely gain it back in eternity. But keep your life, hold on to your life, and you will all likewise perish. My plan, would you like to know what my plan is? My plan, children, is simply this: to receive my faithful servants at the beginning of the tribulation. You will lose your lives serving me. And then, just as the beast's 42 months of authority begins, but before he can hurt even a blade of grass, I will seal my faithful 144,000 bondservants on their foreheads, and I will return these to the earth to serve me there. These faithful 144,000 of the fifth seal martyrs will return to earth endowed with more power than even the devil himself. They will be resurrected saints, the first fruits of the first resurrection, as my word says, and they will serve the rest of you and help you to see the truth. They will have power over the nations, which refers to the demonic realm. These will be the overcomers of Revelation, for they will overcome the beast and his entourage. I will feed them with hidden manna, so they will not be touched by the famines. I will promote them as pillars in my temple, that is, leaders in my church, to replace those who closed their doors and ran away with their tails between their legs at the first hint of governmental resistance. These are they who will sit and sup with me in the marriage supper of the Lamb.
You just had a taste of a feast that God has prepared for you. If you want the whole banquet, listen to our audiobooks on livingwaterpress.com.